Right, it's Kerrang Radio. It is the Temple of Doom with me, Johnny Doom. Metal until 1 a.m. And I've got, I've got two members of Decapitated in the studio. Got Varg and Rasta. How are you doing?
Good, what's up? Hi, man.
I suppose you've been travelling for quite a while to get to the UK, because it's the first date tonight, obviously, of the tour. And yes, you know, last time you were travelling, you didn't have a very good time because you were on a plane, weren't you? Coming to the Damnation Festival. And did the plane crash or something like that?
As you see, we are here, we are alive, you know. But anyway, situation was pretty f***ed up. And, yeah. Because we landing with Boeing...
without the wheels.
Without the wheels.
That was it. It was a Boeing 747. The wheels didn't come down. So the plane landed just on its underside.
Yes. Yeah.
So you were just on this plane. Did they tell you? Did they tell you that it was happening?
1 hour before.
Okay. So you had 1 hour to panic, basically. Yeah.
Rethink
everything. Rethink, see our life, our past, and, you know, to say goodbye to your friends, your family. That was pretty...
Completely. Definitely. We'll talk about it in a minute, but Decapitated, you've had some really, really good points in your career, but lots and lots of really bad times as well. Obviously, there was the coach crash as well, which killed drummer Vitek as well, which was devastating for the band. And, you know, somebody else was in a coma as well from the band as well. Who was that? In the same crash, someone suffered a coma.
Kovan.
Yeah.
Singer.
Yeah,
because
right
now we have Rasta, he's here.
Yeah.
And he replaced Kovan.
Yeah.
We do one album with Kovan, Organic House Gnosis, and, you know, the accident, it happened in Russia.
Yeah.
That was a small tour, that was on a trip for the last show on that tour.
Yeah.
And, that was an accident. My brother, Vitek, passed away. And Kovan is still in a very bad condition.
Yeah.
And it's good that you ask about that, because then we have opportunity to... say a little bit more about Kovan situation, because he got a rehabilitation right now, and of course it takes so much money, and if someone wanna help him, you can visit Kovan Wake Up Kovan website.
Yeah, okay. And Wake Up Kovan website.
Yeah. Wake Up. It's www.wakeupkovan.com.
Yeah.
So you have all information, all info about accounting number and about his health state.
Yeah.
And about how it's possible to help him. So,
So it's been, it's been quite traumatic. You know, you first signed to Earache Records and released Winds of Creation, and things really, you know, kind of were going great for the band. Obviously, that tragedy happened. But also... things like that are quite well known, aren't they, in rock and metal? You know, there's been a lot of tragedies with people on the road, whether it's the bass player from the Deftones or Cliff Burton. And I think travelling around, you know, a lot of people see it as the rock and roll lifestyle. They see all the good parts of it. But of course, as we've just indicated, talking about the plane as well, all this travelling, sometimes it's not that safe.
Yeah, of course. If you spend about almost half of the year on tour, in the tour bus, in a plane, in in a train, in every possible transport,
there's risks.
Is risk is bigger, and you know every musician know about that. It's like a job risk, something like that. But you know it's. I mean, you don't have to think about it too much. It's like you can live in your apartment, you can go to shower, you know.
You've got to get out there. That's what you're saying. You've got to get out there.
You can die even in your toilet or something.
Yeah, yeah. You know. Well, anyway, despite tragedy and despite plane crashes and all your heroics,
yeah, we don't want to be banned. Like people recognize because this is this band with the plane, and they came with no luck. You know,
yeah.
This is a band like.
But no, I was just about to say you made the hard decision in some respects to kind of relaunch the band, get it back together. You got a new drummer as well, new vocalist as well, who's in the studio now.
And also new bass player.
Yeah. New bass player
I'm
as well.
I'm only one original member.
Yeah. And, I suppose you just thought to yourself, well, that's what they would have wanted. They would have wanted Decapitated as a band to carry on. Is that what you thought in some ways?
Yeah, and I think I do good decision about to come back on the stage.
Mm. Yeah.
And we're trying to keep the spirit going, and we play old songs together with new stuff.
Yep.
I can say that because it's easy to recognize we have MySpace page, we have Facebook, lots of people write to us that they want our music, they want this band to play, and
well, you've always played a kind of death metal, but it's always had this really kind of weird, almost backward rhythms kind of feel to it as well. You've always pushed the boundaries of death metal. Do you still feel like there's a lot of riffs and ideas within you? Are you excited about it?
I think so. If I practice, if I take guitar and spend a couple hours to play and practicing all the time, then suddenly riffs are just came, in natural, like natural thing, in natural way.
Well, you
and I think it's still lots riffs and lot ideas to come into death metal music still.
Yeah, because I don't know how you got into death metal music. I suppose the first bands that got me into it, death metal really, I suppose, was things like Celtic Frost, and then Possessed, and then going
death,
into things like Morbid Angel, and things like that. But death metal seems to be going strong. There's still a strong following for it, and lots of festivals and things like that, isn't it?
I think so. Yeah. I know right now Cannibal Corpse together with Behemoth, they have tour over the Europe, and they have really, really good response from fans. Like they have 1,000 to 2,000 people every show, every night. So
you got together and recorded the album Carnival Is Forever, which I played a few tracks from. Was it tough getting the band back into that Decapitated sound, or did it click straight away?
It was different.
Yeah.
It was different for me. And that was a lot of things I had to learn again, how to practice, how to work with new people, with the lineup. But, we have great drummer.
Yeah.
He's from Austria. His name is Kerrang.
Yeah.
He's very good. He's very fast. When I came with idea, with new riff, in a couple seconds, he got idea how to create drum parts for this.
Mm-hmm.
And we have Rasta.
Yeah.
Amazing.
You are amazing.
Thank you, I know.
Everything is different right now. It's the same name. It's the same name of the band. It's the same kind of spirit. I'm the main person. I'm the main
member from the old days. Yeah.
So I create music, and but the rest of the guys are great musicians. And
excellent. Good luck to you, and just keep going and stay out of trouble and don't crash or sink or burst into flames on stage or something like that. But I'll give out the rest of the dates anyway, because you need to go and see Decapitated. Obviously, they've played tonight in Birmingham, but they are at London Camden Dingwalls on the 26th, Manchester Moho on the 27th, Glasgow G2 on the 28th, Reading Sub 89 on the 29th, and Nottingham Rescue Rooms March the 1st, and then finishing up at Bristol Fleece on the 2nd of March. You've still got Aborted on tour with you, but Cyanide Sonority couldn't make it. Is it a different band now? Or is it still Cyanide Sonority?
To be honest, I don't have idea.
Because you've just got here.
No. Cyanide, they cancelled the tour.
Yeah, I think it's a different band.
We have Aborted, and we have another opening band.
Yeah.
It's the Harp Machine.
Yeah, that's it, the Harp Machine.
Yeah.
I saw an email yesterday from Sean, your good friend Sean.
Okay.
So, thanks for coming in, guys. Thanks for having a chat with me. And let's listen to some Decapitated now, and good luck on the rest of the tour, and stay in touch.
Thank you so much, and thank you for this nice conversation, and... I just want to say quickly that we are very happy to be back in the UK.
Mm-hmm.
It was always good to play here.
Yeah.
And I want to invite all the fans of death metal music to come to our tour. I hope we will have good time, good sound.
Mm-hmm.
And all the best.
Thank you very much, Vogue and Rasta. Here's some Decapitated on Kerrang.